Ivan lived with his grandmother. She came from Russia a long time ago, and he called her Babushka. Ivan was a pretty good boy most of the time, but he had a bad habit. He always lost things. He always lost his mittens. One year, he lost 12 mittens. Another year, he lost 7. So his babushka, his grandmother, made him a pair of mittens. She knit them, and they were blue, green, pink, orange, yellow, purple, silver, gold, copper, and red. They were beautiful mittens. She gave them to Ivan, and she said, "Ivan, don't lose these mittens." He said, "Babushka, I would never lose these mittens. These are beautiful. Never. I wouldn't lose these." And so he wore them to school the next day. It had snowed the night before, and as Ivan was walking to school, he saw some deer tracks in the snow. He wondered what it would be like if he put his own hands down to make tracks. So he took his mittens off, put them in his pockets, and put his hands down in the snow.
It's cold.
It was cold. He walked to school, putting his hands in the snow the whole way to see what those tracks looked like. He didn't even notice when one of his mittens fell out of his pocket. It lay there in the snow all by itself. But not for long, because a little mouse came along. That little mouse said, this mitten looks nice and warm and cozy. I think I'll go inside. Went inside, and it was nice and warm and cozy. It wasn't long before a slightly larger nose with pouchy cheeks poked its way into that mitten. This looks really nice and warm and cozy. Could I come in here? It was a squirrel. Had nuts and seeds in its cheeks. And the mouse said, that's right, they eat them. The mouse sang a little song to that squirrel. The song went like this. A house is a house as warm can be. A house for you and a house for me. Come on in. And so that squirrel pushed and shoved and kicked his way into that mitten, and he pulled his big bushy tail in with him. And the two of them sat and ate nuts and seeds. It wasn't long before a larger pink nose, twitching, poked its way into that mitten. It was a rabbit. This mitten looks nice and warm and cozy. It looks nice and warm and cozy. Could I please come in? And so the squirrel sang, a house is a house as warm can be. A house for you and a house for me. Come on in. So that rabbit pushed and shoved and kicked its way into that mitten. The mitten stretched way out. And that rabbit brought its own little cottontail in too. And the three of them sat and ate nuts and seeds. But not for long, because a thin, red, pointy nose poked its way into that mitten. Yeah, it was a fox. This mitten looks nice and warm and cozy, and I see some tasty treats in it. I like to eat mice. Could I come into this mitten? It looks nice and warm and cozy. And the rabbit sang, a house is a house as warm can be. A house for you and a house for me. Come on in. If you want, you can come in. So the fox kicked and pushed and shoved his way into that mitten, and he brought his big red tail with him. He was just thinking about nibbling on a mouse when a big brown muzzle poked its way into that mitten.
Hi.
It was a great big old bear.
Well, this mitten looks nice and warm and cozy. I like a nice warm cozy place in the winter. Could I come in there? Because I'm cold.
The fox said, rats. All right. A house is a house as warm can be. A house for you and a house for me. Come on in, if you have to.
It's so big.
Well, that big old bear pushed and shoved and kicked his way into that mitten. The mitten stretched way out. There was no room for anything else in there. But along came a little hedgehog, just as big as my fist. She said, "Oh, hello! Hello in there! That mitten looks nice and warm and cozy. Could I come in, please?" And the bear, who was a generous soul, said,
"A house is a house as warm can be, a house for you and a house for me. Come on in."
So that hedgehog pushed and shoved and kicked her way all the way in. There was only one place for that hedgehog to sit, right up near the bear's nose. It sat right there by the bear's nose. You know, hedgehogs have quills. And one of those quills kept poking the bear, right, in the nose. Why? Until finally, the bear sneezed so loudly that the mitten flew into the air and all the animals scattered to their real homes. And that mitten came down from the sky and landed on a low branch of a tree. And that's where it was when Yvonne was walking home from school. The mitten was about, well, it was big. It was really big. It was about as big as a window. Yvonne saw that mitten and he said, "That's funny. That mitten looks like my mitten that Babushka made me. But I've got my mittens. I didn't lose them." He reached into his pockets, and he only found one. So he picked up that mitten that he found on the tree, put it on his hand, and carried it home. Then he said, "Babushka, look, Babushka, see? I didn't lose my mittens after all." Babushka looked at him. She looked at that huge mitten very suspiciously. But she said, "I see. I see you didn't lose your mittens. Well, come on in, then, and let's have tea and toast." And that is what they did.